since I was a boy. I wanted to be like Roger Moore, a girl in every port, and gadgets up my sleeve. The world is not enough for the both of us, it seems. So I wish I was James Bond, just for the day. Kissing all the girls, blow the bad guys away.
Step on rakes.
Heart rate coming down. Good. Thank you. Let me know straight away if there are any changes.
Wait. What's going on?
We got a call. They identified the poison your girlfriend ingested.
Poison?
I'm afraid so. She's a very lucky girl. It's been touch and go, but now we're able to treat her.
So she's going to be all right, yeah?
She's not out of the woods yet. There's a chance of kidney damage. The drug she consumed is very dangerous.
Wait, hang on. Who called in, gave you the information?
They didn't say. Don't worry. The police will be looking into all that.
Say goodnight to Auntie Brenda.
Come here. Merry Christmas. See you in the morning.
What about Malcolm? Night, sweetheart.
Auntie Brenda and her new husband, Malcolm, staying at ours for Christmas. Malcolm's a total drip.
Callum. Don't we like it? It was just something stupid we bought on holiday.
What'd you get?
It's an antique spell book.
What'd you get him that for?
I thought he might like it.
Hope it's not evil.
No, it's just a fake tourist gift.
I'm off to bed.
But you've not opened the rest of your presents.
I'll open them later. Thanks, Auntie Brenda.
Yes, very efficient, Mrs. But for some reason, I'm not smiling.
Well, you've just witnessed some intense shredding. Perhaps some more shredding will cheer you up.
I don't think so. You know, if I was suspicious, I'd say I was experiencing the first stages of silly-acquired sadness syndrome. But that can't be right, can it?
Oh, no. Don't be a silly associate of such nonsense.
Well, if you're sure, I suppose I'd better inspect the rest of the hospital. I feel the urge to sigh a little.
If you take this job seriously, you're made to feel guilty if you don't dedicate your whole life and soul to it.
Oh, right. So, because I don't stay here till 6 o'clock every evening, because I don't feel guilty, because I don't always turn up to staff
meetings,
and I don't always fill out pointless bloody forms, then in some way I'm not taking my job seriously.
That's not what I'm saying, Dominic.
Hang on a second. Had you thought for 1 second that maybe I've got the balance right?
I would love to have your attitude. Believe me, it would make my life a whole lot easier.
You could always leave.
What?
You know, follow the trend.
I don't want to leave.
Yeah, well, on that subject, it's what, 4:30? I'd love to chat, but I'm well and truly out of here. I don't get overtime.
Cheers, Tom.
And tonight, when the kids are finally in bed, and I nosedive another bottle of red wine, I won't even have that much guilt.
See you tomorrow.
Yeah.
Finest secret agent, licensed to kill, mixing business with girls and thrills.